strongly voids Staphylococcus, commonly also known as S. staphylococcus. This is very short parasite, and few of the important aspects of this parasite that you have to remember. So we are going to discuss about this parasite. So always you know, in parasitology, the first feature that we are going to discuss is morphological form, or how is the organism character, how is the character of S. staphylococcus. Okay, so S. staphylococcus occurs in two different form. One is adult form. In board you can see the diagram of the adult form. These are the diagram for the adult form of the parasite. One form is female, one form is male. So these two diagrams are female and male of Strongyloides staphylococcus. So one form of this parasite is what? Adult form. Okay, and the second form of the parasite is larval form. See, these two important forms are there. One is adult. These are the diagrams for the adult form, female and male, and one is larval form. Now in larval form, see, again there are two types of larvas in case of S. staphylococcus. One is rabdd form larva and one is pilari form larva. So that part you have to remember. Two types of larvae are there in S. staphylococcus. One form of larva is rabdd form larva and one form of larva is pilari form larva. So have you understood this point? What are the two morphological form, important two morphological form? Adult, female and male, and larval form. One is rabdd form larva and one is pilari form larva. Now we are going to discuss about the larva also. So first we can see the morphology of adult. This parasite belongs from the nematode category. So already we discussed the general characteristic features of nematode. In nematode worm or in nematode parasites, male and female are separate, sexes are separate. So this is a female parasite of S. staphylococcus. This is the male parasite of S. staphylococcus. Now female parasite, again the female is larger as compared to the male. And the characteristic feature of female parasite of S. staphylococcus is this female has two uterus. This two utera is the characteristic feature of S. staphylococcus female. And after the fertilization, death of the male. So again I will repeat this, adult form, female and male. Female is larger as compared to the male. Female has two utera. And after the fertilization, there will be death of the male parasite. Fine. Now again we come back to the female parasite. Female parasite is ovoviviparous. Again another characteristic aspect of the S. staphylococcus female. Female parasite is ovoviviparous. Ovoviviparous means what? After the fertilization, male and female, there will be laying of the eggs by the female parasite. Are you getting this point? Ovoviviparous. Ova is related to what? Egg. Vivi is related to larva. So what is the meaning of this ovoviviparous? After the fertilization, there will be laying of the egg by the female, and immediately the egg will hatch out and there will be release of the larva. Have you understood this point? Ovoviviparous female means after the fertilization, laying of the egg by the female parasite, immediately there will be hatching of the egg or breaking of the egg and release of the larva. Now here again the interesting point that you have to remember is the larva is going to release inside the intestine only. This is another important aspect of the S. staphylococcus. You have understood till here, आतापर्यंत तुम्हाला हे कळलेलं आहे, फर्टिलायझेशन झालेलं आहे, मेल अँड फिमेल पॅरासाइट. फिमेल आपण बघितली ओविपॅरस आहे. ओविपॅरस आहे मग आफ्टर फर्टिलायझेशन काय होणार आहे? एगलिंग ऍक्टिव्हिटी होणार आहे. एगलिंग ऍक्टिव्हिटी नंतर काय होणार आहे? स्क्रॅच hatching, breaking of the egg or hatching of the egg and release of the larva. Egg-laying activity, fertilization where is going to happen? Intestine of the host. Intestine of the host is the place for the fertilization to occur. So after the fertilization, inside the intestine only, there will be laying of the egg inside the intestine and there will be release of the larva inside the intestine. This is the important aspect. So have you understood? म्हणजे फर्टिलायझेशन, ब्रेकिंग ऑफ द एग अँड रिलीज ऑफ द लार्वा हे सगळ्या प्रोसेसेस कुठे होणार आहे? इंटेस्टाइनमध्ये होणार आहे. सो क्लियर अबाउट दिस पॉइंट. नाउ हियर रॅबिडिटी फॉर्म लार्वा अँड फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वा. नाउ टू टाइप्स ऑफ लार्वे आर देर. सो हाउ दिस वन लार्वा इज गोइंग टू डेव्हलप इन टू द अनदर लार्वा, विच विल बी द इन्फेक्टिव्ह फॉर्म, दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन द लाईफ सायकल पार्ट. ओके, सो दिस इज द मॉर्फॉलॉजी ऑफ दिस पॅरासाइट. Another important feature in case of this parasite S. temporalis is, apart from living in the intestine, these two parasites, that is male and female, they can live inside the soil also. See, I will repeat this sentence because this is characteristic feature of the S. temporalis. Apart from living in the intestine of the human being, this parasite also lives inside the soil, in environment, and this is called as free living adult. So, two different forms of S. temporalis are there. One is intestinal form. One is intestinal form, that male and female lives where? Intestine of the human being. And another is free living adults. Free living adults, where they reside? Where they reside? Soil. This is different, or this is something important aspect of the S. temporalis. So to sum up the morphology of the S. temporalis, this is a parasite which occurs in two forms. One is adult, one is larva. Again, the larva is of two form. One is rhabdidi form, one is filari form. Now, female is larger as compared to the male. Female has two uterus. Female is ovoviviparous. That is, inside the intestine, fertilization occur, laying of the egg and release of the larva. So, this form is called as intestinal form. But sometimes it can also occur that this adult parasites, they live inside the soil. So we call it as a free living. They are living inside the soil. They are not living inside the intestine. So as they are living in the environment, in the soil, so we call it as a free living adult. So this is the morphological aspect of the S. temporalis. Now we move to the life cycle. And in the life cycle only, we are going to discuss about these two larvae, rhabdidi form and filari. Now the life cycle of this S. temporalis. Now all of you know that life cycle always starts from the infective form. Here the infective form is not egg. Egg ahe ka, exit form kutla ahe? Larva. So here the infective form is filari form larva. Another important aspect of the S. temporalis. Now from where this filariform larva came, so we are going to focus on that. So for that, again you have to recollect general characteristic feature of nematode. In general, as these parasites belong from the nematode category, so in this nematode category, S. temporalis, molting is one of the very important feature. molting.
So molting means what? Shedding of the cuticle of the larva and again the formation of the new larva. So here already we discussed two forms. One is rapidity form, one is filaria. So what is happening? When there is breaking of the egg, there is first release of the rapidity form larva. Which larva will form first out of these two larva? Rapidity form larva. Egg pasna kaya tayar hona re? Egg madna kaya release hona re? Rapidity form larva. Then what will occur? Molting. The cuticle, the very thin layer, the thin part, the thin shiny part of the skin is called as cuticle. There will be shedding of that cuticle, which is called as molting. And this rapidity form larva get converted into filariform larva. So is this point is clear? This you have to remember, otherwise you are not going to understand the life cycle. Again I will repeat, fertilization is occurring where? Intestine. Female is laying where? Intestine. Breaking of the egg, release of larva. Which larva? Rapidity form larva. Here I have written the filari form, but now we are discussing about the rapidity form. Release of rapidity form larva. Mag kaya honare? Molting will takes place. Means what? Shedding of the old cuticle and there will be new morphological form, that is filari form larva. Is sagri process kuthe hoti hai? Inside the intestine only. Okay. So the rapidity form larva and filari form larva. We actually compare keda. Tar, there is a comparative point in this form. Rapidity form larva and filari form larva. Both these larva has one similar point. They are actively motile. They can actively move from one place to another. So active motility is similarity. And the difference is rapidity form has small mouth and buccal cavity as compared to the filari form. This is the difference. There is no separate diagram for rapidity form and filari form larva. But one similar point is both larvae are actively motile. And the difference point is what? Rapidity form larva has small esophagus, not small esophagus, small buccal cavity as compared to the filari form larva. Fine. So now this is the description of the larva. Now we come to the life cycle. Manje rapidity form cha conversion kasha madhe zalele filari form madhe. Apan ha ek part baghitla jar tumcha lakshat ala asel tar hi sagli process kuthe hoti intestine of the human being. Apan ek dusra pan part baghitla jya madhe free living adults tumcha lakshat asel atta just apan baghitla manje se male ani female fertilization kuthe hota inside the soil. Karan free living adults kuthe rahta hai soil. So automatically the fertilization takes place where? Soil. Soil madhe fertilization zalyanantar parat tees process repeat honar hai na. Laying of the egg by female, breaking of the egg and release of the larva. Larva, first larva kutla release honar hai? Rapidity form larva. And that rapidity form larva will mold and again it get converted into the filari form larva. Mande soil asude kiwa intestine asude. Shevti at the end stage kutla larva lela hai? Filari form larva. हा मेन पॉइंट है आणि मग इथूनचं इथून पुढचं लाइफ सायकल तुमच्यासाठी समजण्याला तुम्हाला सोपं जाईल. सो नाउ वी डिस्कस द लाइफ सायकल. द इन्फेक्टिव फॉर्म इज फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वा. नाउ हाउ द ह्यूमन बीइंग गेट्स और हाउ द ह्यूमन बीइंग एक्वायर द इन्फेक्शन. सी दिस लार्वा फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वा कुठल्याही पॅरासाइट मध्ये, हा एक रूल तुम्ही लक्षात ठेवा, कुठल्याही पॅरासाइट मध्ये जेव्हा इन्फेक्टिव फॉर्म हा लार्वा आहे तो लार्वा फक्त आणि फक्त फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वाच असणार आहे. रॅपिडिटी फॉर्म लार्वा कॅनॉट बी अ इन्फेक्टिव फॉर्म. दिस यू हॅव टू रिमेंबर. फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वा ओनली कॅन इन्फेक्ट द होस्ट. सो ऑलवेज अँड ऑलवेज द इन्फेक्टिव फॉर्म इज व्हॉट? फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वा. अँड हाऊ द फिलारी फॉर्म लार्वा कशापासून तयार होतं? रॅपिडिटी फॉर्म. So fine, this point is clear. Now how the human being acquires the infection? This is our point to discuss. Now this larva, it's passed along with the feces. Where are these processes? If it is a intestine, where are these processes happening inside the intestine? So obviously along with the feces, if this parasite, not parasite, if this larva is there in the intestine, so it is natural that it will pass along with the feces into the environment. And human beings get infected by contamination of this contaminated by drinking contaminated water and food. If the food and water is contaminated with that fecal soil, so the human being will acquire the infection. So this is the point. So how the human being acquire this infection of the Strongyla? So human being acquire this infection following the contact with fecally contaminated soil. Fecally contaminated soil with the help of auto-infection, this larva will reach to human being. Now, if there is consumption, this larva will reach, this filariform larva will directly reach to the intestine. And if the larva is, this filariform larva is there in soil, because we have seen the two forms, one is intestinal form and one form is inside the soil. So if the larva is inside the soil, it can penetrate the skin. And if the larva is inside the intestine, it can penetrate the mucous membrane. So have you understood this point? Skin and mucous membrane. Filariform larva is the infective form. How it will reach to the human being? With the help of fecally contaminated soil. Okay. We also call it as auto-infection. Or else, if it is inside the soil, this larva, it can penetrate the skin. If it is inside the intestine, it can penetrate the mucous membrane of the intestinal mucus. So finally, filariform larva is there inside the human being. Now after the penetration part, skin and mucous membrane, this larva, here the features are because of this larva. This is very, very important part that you have to remember in the Escher coralis. This larva will reach where? Bloodstream. It is but natural, if it penetrates the skin, it will reach to the blood, it will penetrate the mucous membrane, again intestinal mucus, again it will reach to the blood. So this will be a very simple thing. So it will reach to the bloodstream. From bloodstream, it will reach where? Lungs. So penetrating the skin and mucous membrane, filariform larva. Then reaching to the bloodstream or invading the bloodstream, reaching to the lungs. From lungs, it will reach to alveoli. See, this is very simple process. From lungs, it will reach to alveoli. From alveoli, it will reach to bronchial tree. Is it this? Simple process is there. Bloodstream, madna kuthe aalele? Lungs. From lungs, where? Alveoli. And from alveoli, where? Bronchial tree. Now, when it reaches to the bronchial tree, again it ascends. Fine. It ascends from the intestine. Zar penetration kelele, tari ascending manner madhe aahe. जर इंटेस्टिनल ह्यूमन मधून वरती आले तरी असेंडिंग मॅनर इट्स बट नॅचरल सो व्हेन दिस लार्वा कम्स एट दिस ब्रॉन्कियल ट्री आता हे सगळं कोण डेव्हलप करतंय कुठे कोण कोणाचं जर्नी चालू आहे फिलारीफॉर्म लार्वा ओके सो इट असेंड्स अगेन फ्रॉम द ब्रॉन्कियल ट्री इट असेंड्स अँड इट कम ऍट द इट क्रॉल ऍट द एपिग्लॉटिस दिस इज लार्वा ऑलरेडी आय टोल्ड यू ऍक्टिव्ह मोटिलिटी यू डोंट हॅव टू फॉरगेट अबाउट द ऍक्टिव्ह मोटिलिटी ऑफ दिस लार्वा. As this larva is actively motile, it will crawl at the epiglottis and it will get swallowed up. Isn't it? It's very interesting. How is the journey? From bloodstream to lungs, from lungs to alveoli, from alveoli to bronchial tree. Then it ascends, it crawls at the epiglottis and again it will get swallowed back to the intestine. So filariform larva again gets swallowed back where? Intestine. Inside the intestine, from this filariform larva, there will be the development of the adult form, male as well as female. So are you getting this point? Once that larva crawl, once that larva gets swallowed, reach to the intestine, again it will develop into what? Adult, male and female. The same process will occur inside the intestine, fertilization will occur, death of the male worm, laying of the egg, hatching of the larva. Which larva? Rabidiform larva. Again the whole thing takes place and which larva will come out? The filariform larva. And now this filariform larva is ready to infect the another host, because it can pass around the feces, it can reach to the soil and it can infect the another host. So in this way the life cycle of the Escher coralis continues. Okay, so this is very simple life cycle. Ithe apan kutla dusra host baghitlay ka? Whole process is taking place only in one host, that is human being. So life cycle of Escher coralis is simple life cycle, because it involves only one host. So we will repeat the life cycle. Simple life cycle. Who is the host? Human being is the host. Who is the infective form? Filariform larva is the infective form. How does filariform larva infect the host? Because it can pass along the feces, it is present inside the contaminated soil, and by consumption of this fecally contaminated soil with the help of the food water that get contaminated with the help of this soil, the human being can consume. And if it is inside the soil, it can penetrate the skin. So if it is consumed, it can penetrate the intestinal lumen. So penetrating the skin and penetrating the mucous membrane, reaching to the bloodstream, reaching to the lungs. From bloodstream it will ascend again to lungs, again ascend the alveoli, again ascend the bronchial, ascend, crawl over the epiglottis, get swallowed back to the intestine. Filariform larva developed into the adult, fertilization, laying of the egg, release of the larva. Which larva? Rhabditiform larva. Rhabditiform larva will mold, get converted into the filariform larva. Fine. So this is interesting aspect of the Aster coralis. Another interesting aspect is related to Rhabditiform larva, about this parasite. So this Rhabditiform larva can be developed in two different ways. Rhabditiform larva, what is the source of Rhabditiform larva? From the egg. The eggs that can be laid by the female after the fertilization. So this is the. But Rhabditiform larva can develop in two different ways. The first way is they can mature into the infective filariform larva. So very simple. Inside the intestine, break of the egg, breaking of the egg, release of the larva, Rhabditiform larva directly get matured into the